First story is titled, Am I the a-hole for not wanting to share my birthday with my dead twin anymore? My 19th birthday is this Friday, and I told my mom and dad, I don't want to do anything if we are going to have the birthday for my twin too. I was an identical twin, and me and my sister were born early, and she died a few hours after we were born. Every single birthday, since I was little, has also been a birthday for her. We go to her grave and put flowers on it, and every gift has always had both her and my name on it. Mom gets really sad and always cries for a long time, and I have always felt overshadowed on my birthday. The grave visits and flowers and all have always been mandatory, and I was never allowed to have friends over or have a party until after we did it. I want to go to dinner with my boyfriend for my birthday at his house, and then I'm going to watch movies with my friends. Mom is upset I'm not making the hour-long drive Friday to do the grave ritual and is really sad. And my dad is making me feel guilty since I'm their only living daughter and stuff. I told my mom I don't want to share my birthday with a sister I never even knew, and I'm done with sharing with a ghost since this has been my entire life. My parents are really upset, and now I feel really bad and maybe I should suck it up, but I am just so sick of it. Edit. Okay, so I didn't expect this much attention, so I'll try to answer some questions I've gotten a lot of. First of all, I don't live at home. I live on campus, which is an hour away from my hometown. Second, I don't care if my parents go. They can do whatever they want, just without me. I've hated going to the cemetery since I was like 13 and realized how weird it was. But my parents were very my house, my rules about going. I don't like standing over the grave of a dead baby just to pretend to feel sadder than I do. I know it's hard on my parents, but I just want to have a birthday without being guilted by them. My mom gets quiet and cries a little whenever my sister is brought up, and it's turned up to 100 on my birthday. She died the same day we were born. It sucks seeing her like that. I love my parents, but you can love someone and not like their choices too. Also, I have about 10 unopened messages right now. I won't be reading them. Two of the ones I got earlier were really mean, and one said I should have died instead, so screw off. Not reading any more DMs. Don't waste your time. If you're afraid I won't see your opinion in the comments, try getting over it. Now for the comments. Not the a-hole. Maybe I would look at this differently if you and your family had actually known your twin, but they basically died during birth. That is truly awful. But you never had any connection to them, so sharing a birthday with them is almost a bit morbid. Like instead of having a fun day with activities you get to choose, you get to have a memorial instead. That's a bummer, and I can understand why you want it to stop. I know it must be hard on your mother, but maybe she should start respecting the feelings of her actual living child. I agree with this so much. I try to be understanding when it comes to grief. I never lost a child, so who am I to judge? But putting the dead baby's name on the living one's present? That's just weird. It sounds like the mom never processed her grief completely, and now she's not grieving. She's wallowing. That is not healthy for anyone. OP, you are not the a-hole, and I hope you have a very happy birthday. I also feel like the family could visit the grave any other day of the year. It's not like it has to be on the birth date. They are choosing to make every one of OP's birthday a sad day for them instead of letting them enjoy it. This was my exact thought. They could celebrate the daughter they have on her birthday and memorialize the one they lost on the following day. Instead, they're choosing to prioritize the lost over the living. It's terribly unfair to OP. The one day, literally, that should be all about her is instead all about a ghost. Giving her gifts with the deceased baby's name on them makes OP a mere proxy. Go reclaim your birthday, OP. Find a way that makes you happy because you deserve that. Her parents should be celebrating the fact that OP survived instead of mourning the one that sadly didn't make it. Not the a-hole. Your parents need to move on. I'm not saying they shouldn't still be sad on the day, but forcing you to share your birthday with a dead sister isn't healthy after 19 years. Now for the next story. Am I the a-hole for asking to have my deceased brother's room? My brother passed away at the age of 16 when I was only 9 years old. I'm now 16 and I share a room with my 14-year-old brother. I hate sharing a room with him because I can't change in my room because he's always in the room playing video games. When he has friends over, I have to sleep on the couch, and I just don't feel comfortable sharing my room with a boy. My mom has a room where no one is using, but it was my older brother's room that she still hasn't even touched. Everything is in the same place he left it in. Even the garbage he left on the floor. His garbage is still full and his bed is still unmade. She doesn't allow anyone to go into that room. If you even go one step into it, my mom will ground you. I love my brother, but I don't think leaving his room in the same place it was left in before he passed away is going to bring him back. I recently asked my mom if I could have my brother's room. She got really angry at me for even asking. She told me that I am being selfish and that if I touch her son's room, she sent me to live with my dad. I told her I'd rather live with my dad because I have privacy there, which really didn't help the situation. My aunt sent me a message saying how I'm an awful person, that losing a child is one of the hardest things to deal with, and if me sharing a room helped my mom, then I should just deal with it. Am I the a-hole for asking my mom to have my older brother's room? Now for the top comments. Info, am I interpreting the situation here correctly? Are you a 16-year-old girl living in the same room as your 14-year-old brother? Yes, I am, and I honestly do not like it. Are you in the US? If so, that's straight up not legal, as well in certain parts. If not, I'd definitely try to move in with your dad if possible. Honestly, I'd be doing that no matter what. I'm in Canada. Not the a-hole. She is making a 16-year-old girl share a room with her 14-year-old brother when there is another bedroom available. That's not cool. Holding on to a bedroom for this long untouched is not healthy. She needs to start letting go. If you truly do want to live with your dad, you can just call her out and see if she is bluffing or not. Either way, it may result in a better situation for you. Right, living this way with an untouched bedroom of a deceased child is something people do, but only indefinitely if they have no other living children in the house. This is taking resources away from your living children. Does your love of a memory outweigh that of your other living children? What kind of message is that? If I lost one of my children, I know I'd be an absolute wreck for a while. But 7 years? You need to care for your other children. I know they are separated, but I depend on my husband to slap some sense into me at this point. Her living children depend on her. She needs to step up or let them go to their dads. Either way, she can't keep all three of them like this. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for telling my future sister-in-law what my brother-in-law said about me grieving my son? This is a horrible situation, and I might have ruined my entire relationship with my in-laws, but I just want to hear an outside perspective to see if I made a mistake. I, female 28, lost my son, Thomas. He was only 2 months and 9 days old. He died of acute bronchiolitis. He was given pediatric care and he passed away shortly. It was hard and exhausting to bear. I had my family with me most of the time. My in-laws would visit from time to time since they're busy planning for my brother-in-law's wedding. His fiancée visited me at my house, which was really nice of her, even though my brother-in-law would tell us he was busy, but he had to show up with her. A few days ago, my mother-in-law wanted me to go over to her house to take my input in regard of my brother-in-law's wedding planning, but I told her I wasn't in the mood for that. I apologized several times and it clearly got to my brother-in-law. He visited me at my house alone, which was unusual, and talked about my son's death, and said it was expected since my son was suffering from other health issues. He said that I still can have another healthy baby and name him Thomas, and take good care of him this time. I was dumbfounded. Then he casually started talking about his wedding next month and how he needs me and my husband in our best condition, because he needs us at the wedding. Basically talking about how his in-laws are upper middle class and how everything needs to be perfect. I lost it when he told me to stop ignoring this event and host the guests, his in-laws, with smiles and greetings. I told him I wasn't planning on attending because I'm still grieving my son and will only ruin their good time and perfect wedding. He got upset with my response and said he'd get his mom to talk to me about it. Last night, while his fiancé was talking to me like she does every week, and I told her about my conversation with my brother-in-law and what he told me, and told her I may not be able to attend, she sounded upset with my brother-in-law and apologized to me on his behalf. The next day, my brother-in-law showed up and berated me, saying he had a huge argument with his fiancé after I told her what he said and said that I was being bitter and disrespectful. He said his fiancé is now refusing to talk to him and is upset I might have ruined it for him. He left after we argued, and his mom sent me a text telling me that I wasn't in the right to run to his fiancé and get her involved and cause issues. I ended up telling them I wasn't going to attend a wedding after they said I tried to ruin it, and we haven't talked since then. I feel so hurt and unable to think straight. I was just expressing my hurt feelings and how inappropriate he was being. Added to say that I lost my son not too long ago. He passed away on August. Now for the top comments. Holy Christ. Firstly, I am so sorry for your loss. It was not your fault, not even close. The fact that your in-laws care more about their wedding than the loss of your baby is freaking disgraceful. You want to talk about proper decorum, that is not how you go about it. You don't need these awful people in your life, telling you hurtful crap to manipulate you to bending over backwards for them and their needs. Screw them, not the a-hole. I can't imagine this happening to someone in my family and having any reaction other than, "We are so sorry for your loss and we are heartbroken with you. You are absolutely welcome to still attend our wedding, but if you are unable to participate in planning or to attend as you grieve, we absolutely understand." Hell, unless I'd already committed to a venue and vendors and pay deposits, I think I'd want to push the wedding back 6 months, or a year, to ease any feelings of obligations they might have, and free myself and my partner to be there for them. At least to me, a wedding is just a day, and if I'm going to be with that person forever, I have the rest of my life to throw a party about it. Not the a-hole, obviously. One easy way to prevent your fiancé from hearing about crappy, rude, and disrespectful things you say is to not say crappy, rude, and disrespectful things. But then, you'd be asking him to take responsibility for his own actions. The horror! OP, I have been in a similar place. May I challenge your brother-in-law to a duel of insults? I have many words I'd like to share with him. Not the a-hole. Not the a-hole. Your brother-in-law was being an insensitive, self-centered jerk, and his fiancée had every right to know he was acting that way about their wedding. If she understands you not wanting to attend a wedding because you're grieving, then good. She's a normal human. No one should guilt you into forcing yourself to act a certain way while you're grieving. And as to what your brother-in-law said about your son, if someone had said that to me, I would never even look at them again, let alone attend and play host at their wedding. To be honest, she has a good heart and is very respectful. It's clear to me that my brother-in-law acts differently whenever she is around, and it's not okay, as he seems to be having two-faced personality and attitude. And that's the end of this video, folks. As always, leave a comment and hit like and subscribe. And if you want more of this content, turn your notification on to get updated on the latest videos. And I'll catch you in the next one. Stay safe.